Hello everybody, I'm GHG and welcome back to this tutorial series, and in today's episode we are going to take a look at creating a remote crafting bench. As you have seen, you need to create a new listener once again and finish. And inside of here I want to do event handler, because we're gonna open a workbench, as it's called in the coding spigot. Public void on player interact, player interact event E, and then we're gonna check import event handler if e.getItem does not equal null, and then we're gonna check if e.getItem.getType.equalsMaterial the workbench. So if they click inside the area of a crafting bench, it's got workbench inside the spigot API. And to do open the workbench on the player is actually quite simple. There's only like 4 lines of code in the whole plugin we're going to create now, or in the whole class. It's going to be e.getPlayer.open workbench, and then it will require a location and a boolean. And for the location, it's actually the location of the workbench you want to open. And since we do not have any workbench we want to open on a certain location, we can just fill in null, and it will open a workbench on the location of the player. But there is no actual workbench, so that's why there's a boolean over here. And this boolean is actually whether to force the opening of the workbench or not, because if there's no workbench on the location you fill in on the first argument, arg0, then you can still open a workbench by just saying that you want to force it open. And actually it's quite simple, it's as simple as this to open a workbench. I also want to check if e.getItem does not equal null, and e.getAction.equalsAction.RightClickAir, so that the workbench is not placed but it's just clicked in the air. And then we check for the type workbench, and then we open a workbench on the location of the player, but there's no workbench there, so we true. We set force to true. If you set force to false, it will not open a workbench in this case, because there's no workbench on the location of the first argument. And that's it as far as the coding goes. Real simple to open a remote workbench, but it's quite a nice gimmick. And let's go check this out on the server. So inside Minecraft, I started up the server, and let's go take a look at what we have created. And to do this, I'm just gonna grab 2 planks, and I'm just gonna grab a crafting table. And as you can see, if I right click in the air, it will open a crafting table, and you can actually craft in it. You can craft sticks, you can craft whatever you like. And if I do right click, it will place the bench. Right click in the air, it will open it. And that's it for today's episode. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. If you got any feedback or suggestions, there's a link to our Discord channel down below in the description box. Or just post a comment. Do whatever you like. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Bye.